Students, welcome you back for the last lecture series on line codes. Here we are going to study about PSD, power spectral density of bipolar and Manchester. Outline of the lecture series, we'll calculate power spectral density, graphical representation of bipolar and Manchester line code, advantages of these two line codes and comparison of four different line codes. How do we represent a bipolar signal? Bipolar signal, other name is called as AMI, alternative mark inversion. Mark has been defined in terms of digital data 1. So if I represent bit 1, we can say it is having mark signal. So state 1 is having a mark signal, and each signal is going to have plus and negative A volts. 0 pulse, bit 0 will occupy no pulse. So we call it as alternatively, bit 1 is going to have plus volts, negative volts, plus volts, negative volts. So it is called as alternative mark inversion AMI. Here the pulse are represented in terms of NRZ, therefore it will occupy the entire time period TB. First bit is 1, the blue indicates the digit sequence in your digital data transmitted in a channel. Bit 1, so it is positive pulse. 0, 0. Bit 1, positive already, therefore this will become negative. Again bit 1, positive because previously it was negative. Again 0, 0. Bit 1, previously it is positive, therefore this will become negative. So positive, negative, positive, negative. Alternatively, it changes the thing. So we call it as alternative mark inversion. The advantage of the system is error detection is possible. There is no signal drooping. It occupies lesser bandwidth than unipolar and polar. So the occupation of your bandwidth is very much lesser. Drooping is not available. How to calculate the power spectral density of this bipolar or AMI signaling? So again, we know how to do it. First, we need to calculate the lower order term 0 and 1. So we'll assume only two bits, 0 and 1. How to calculate it? Probability of chances occurring is half. Probability of chances occurring is half. Half bit for 1, half bit for 0. So you'll have it as half. Now we'll go for the higher order terms. Higher order terms, we'll have it as the combination is 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. There are four possibilities. So you let us 1 by 4 and the value is going to be 1 by 4. So these are the combinations you can make in finding out the power spectral density. So you need to calculate what is the power spectral density of AMI signaling. Output pulse is the input pulse multiplied by the XF of F. So this X of F can be calculated as an autocorrelation properties with respect to lower order and higher order. Lower order and higher order, R naught is half. So we have taken here Rn, higher order terms is taken as 1 by 4. And it is a complex conjugate signal. So 1 minus cos 2 is be written in terms of sine squared by 2. So that's how your 2, 2 gets cancelled and you have P of F squared divided by TB sine squared value. But usually a time domain signal X of T, when it is converted to frequency domain X of F, it's a rectangular pulse, will convert into sync pulse. So we are converting a sine function into a sync function. So that has been possible by using this mathematical identity. So this is called as sync. This is called as sync. Okay. Next we move on to the next type of code called as Manchester biphase or split phase encoding. The duration of the symbol is divided into two halves. And there is a transition at the center point of every symbol period. Okay, so these two are the important things to be noted. There is a center point transition, it's divided into two halves. So we'll have the signal now to be taken. Positive pulse, if it is bit 1, it will have half time period. So your signals will, if it is bit 1, half time is going to be positive pulse and another half will be negative pulse. If it is bit 0, you will have negative half time period, positive half time period. So combination of these two pulses are the representative of your signal over here. See here, one time period is fully going to be 0 to TB. Half time it is positive, negative. And it is again negative, positive. Again it is negative, positive. So there is no DC component present over here. So in this signal you can find out advantages. There is no DC component. Therefore there is no signal droop. And it is easy to synchronize with your clock pulse. So these three are the important advantage that this Manchester line coding forms a finite one for all the line codes available in the present digital communication area. So how to calculate the power spectral density of split phase? Why do we have a split phase? Because each phase will have positive and negative volts. So we call it as there is a split phase encoding, the other name. So how to calculate? Here we know that it's equivalent to your polar system. The higher order terms, since you have plus and minus alternatively, so higher order terms is equal to 0. The lower order, it is plus and minus volts, therefore the lower order will be 1. So your calculation with respect to only lower order, therefore we'll have this pulse to be represented as x y of f in terms of p of f squared divided by tb. So what are the application in which the Manchester coding can be used? All our Ethernet cable works under this Manchester coding. And all your near field RF communication, which is your RFID. Remember, wherever we go for retail shops, whether it is going to be in any hypermarkets or in any other places, all your RFID tags are your near field RF communication technology. And this RFID tags will try to use a type of line code internally as a Manchester line coding. So that is what has been given in this slide. You can see how efficiently your pulses are having no DC component. Your clock has been synchronized with your data, and this is how your Manchester waveform looks into it. Where do we apply? Since it's a synchronizing data stream, we are applying it in Ethernet card of lower data rates. And we apply in RFID systems. So how does this power spectral density of all the four different line codes leak into it? So it's a comparison statement. We have studied unipolar, it is 0.5. For polar, it will become 1. Whereas in bipolar, it occupies double the bandwidth. You can see how the sync function has been defined. And in Manchester, it is occupies with a synchronization. In both the components of bipolar and Manchester, there is no DC component. Since you don't have any DC component, there is no drooping of your messages. And this is taken with respect to the books Coach, and the figure is taken with respect to Lathi and Ding. Okay. You have bipolar signal sync, you have Manchester here split phase, you have polar. So all four things have been defined in terms of NRZ calculation and RZ calculation. So comparison of your various line coding schemes. Unipolar, it is very simple, bandwidth is low, but no synchronization, no correction. Whereas in unipolar, you will have moderate bandwidth. When you come for bipolar, you will have signal error capability. This is one of the advantages of your bipolar NRZ scheme. Whereas if you come for Manchester, you have clock synchronization and greater bandwidth. So greater bandwidth and clock synchronization advantages. And your single error capability is the advantages of your bipolar. So with this, we conclude the lecture series on what is meant by line codes, how to calculate your power spectral density of four different line codes. And finally, we say that in the present communication area, We will be using either a bipolar NRZ which has the capability of error detection, and Manchester as the best one because it occupies the greater bandwidth as well as it is capable of being used in Ethernet cables and RFID protocols. Since it occupies no DC level, there is no drooping of your messages and you have a split phase encoding to be available. Thank you for your patience listening.